Welcome to this video for one more special game accessory from a company well known to do really highly detailed and functional game inserts and laser cut tokens, as well as very functional game accessories. And what we're going to see is the custom insert for one game pool that really needs one. And this is no other than Anachrony, which has a ton of stuff within the box. So it is not an option, it is a necessity to have a custom-made insert for a game like that. Let's quickly open the box and see what we see, what we get inside. We have already assembled the custom tray, so we're going to break it down for you and see what does each section of this custom tray from LaserOx. So we have the rulebooks, you can see that they fit here, the pad, and then the game boards, the player game boards that fit nicely here with all the special boards from the expansions. Let's take one more dive and see what we get following the uncovering of the box. So what we see here is this special tray, which has the faction cards here and the laser cut nuclear token with the dice. This is you can use it both for cards, it's just we use them for those special dice and those special tokens. You can store them here, very nice. I'm gonna come back to those in a bit. So following the digging in, we see this board, which goes on top of the main board, different boards from players and expansions also, that they lock very nicely and hold everything together. And now let's go to this nice baby here, which is, haven't seen this before in a custom tray. It opens like a trapdoor. So you see, it's not like a removable cup. It holds itself still, so you can open it and close it very nicely. Nice detail. And here you have the PP tokens and also the nuclear tokens. These are replacement laser cut tokens for those. You can see the detail. Much more nice, much more fancy. They glow. They have this nice greenish effect. So you can also get those from this company, LaserOx. So I haven't seen again this trapdoor, which is very nice for custom tray compartments. So we put it outside. And then we get this section here with these tokens. These are the breakthrough tokens, where you can have different icon on the at the bottom of each of the breakthrough. So you can easily set them separately. You can remove the cap and you can easily take them out and put them back in as needed during your gameplay. And then everything fits nicely together and locks securely. One very nice detail that I really loved about this tray is, as you can see, maybe you can see it with this camera, but there is the logo of Anachrony. And this is very important. I haven't seen it before in custom trays, because when you want to put them back together, in order to get the same sequence of boxes and easily get everything in its original place, you can follow the diagram and create the Anachrony symbol, so you can sort its box and its compartment in the respective correct place. So you don't even have to check out the instruction manual to see how you fit everything together, because once you set it up and you fix it, then you can sort its compartment on the, at its original place following the Anachrony logo. Very nice detail. So going into undigging, we see this very nice tray that you can easily take it out of the rest, and you can have within this a section for the super projects that you can get in this area. You can fit them very nicely here, and the collapsing tiles that you can see in this section. Everything fits nicely together, it doesn't move from its original place, easily stored and inserted and removed from the tray. Next, we have this box here, which opens again with the lid. Take a note of the four different symbols, because this box contains the four different workers, very special worker. So it's the genius, the scientist, the engineer, and the administrator. You can easily understand what's in the box from the four different symbols. And here we have the respective worker types that we're going to fit into our miniatures and into our exoskeleton suits. So again, This is identified very easily from the markings. Next, we have this nice drawer that slides nicely and easily within here. Again, you can identify from the markers what you get inside, what you expect. It's the four different players start up setup, so you get the stands, the base stands, the bases, the warp tokens, and also here in this version we also have some laser cut tokens we're going to show into detail later on. You can get us an extra add-on from Laser Ops. Very nicely done, one for each player. It's a four player game, slides easily, and you're ready to start with the player count you have and get what you need for each player. Next, we have this section. I'm removing it all together because it has an upper part and a bottom part. In the bottom part, we have the Paradox Laser Cap tokens. Again, this is special tokens. You can also get as an add-on. The die from the expansion and additional markers from the expansion. Very nicely done. On top of that, we have this box here that fits very nicely. And you have again the anomaly tiles. The timeline tiles, which you can again open from the side, remove easily and fit nicely in this section. Holds it very nicely together and sits on top of each other. This was located here. Next, we have this nice little box, which again has this draw compartment that you remove, and what you get inside are two different types of cards, the mine pool deck and recruit pool cards. So you have the different type of cards here sitting in this nice box. Again, you can even sleeve them because I always like to take these details. People don't take under consideration the space you want to have for sleeving. You can sleeve them, and again they fit nicely in here. Okay, then the next thing, maybe you can see it, I'm just gonna flip here the box so you can see at the bottom we have this section over here. This stand holds very nicely together the anomaly tiles and the building tiles, sorted and organized, fitting very well together. Okay, let's take this out of the way. So here what we have is another section, two boxes sitting on top of each other. Let's take the bottom one. We have the resource cube, so the different source of the game, nice tray. And on top of that, check the detail, how they interlock, very nicely done. They don't fiddle, they stick together very nicely. So what we have on the top is this troll with the water tokens. Out of the way, keep two. Next we have this box here, easily removed, with a sliding door. So what we have inside is the different cards, two compartments, the different cards for the expansions. Again, nice detail, you can sleeve them and they fit very nicely, no problem there. Nice detail, functional and steady. So the rest of the compartments are the miniatures for each of the players. I'm just going to remove one. We're going to come back to the miniatures to show you that the rest of the space is exactly what fits left, is left for fitting the board of the game. So again, the board of the game doesn't fiddle around. It doesn't usually, the custom trays, they don't have it. They have it at the top. This one is stored at the bottom and it doesn't move around. So we remove the board of the game. It's folded. And then what's left inside are the five compartments with the different miniatures. Okay, so now let's set the boxes aside and focus on the eye candy, which are the miniatures. I'm gonna take all the boxes out. So what is left is the plain back of the box. We're just going to remove it from here. And I'm gonna show you the functional wooden boxes for each of the miniatures. So one by one, they all open from the sideways. So you can open them like that. You see, you can open from both sides, I believe. You open them, remove the lid, and I don't know if you can see the detail, they all slide very nicely together, and you also have the faction card sitting vertically in the middle of the box, separating the top from the bottom miniatures. It's a nice detail, also very well thought. So I'm going to remove one miniature I'm gonna come and zoom in on the miniatures because they're also painted in our copy. But you can see how they slide with ease out of the section. Then you get the faction card and the rest of the miniature at the back. I'm not gonna remove everything, there is no need. But look at the detail and look at how functional this tray is. This is the same for each of the factions. So you don't have to worry, first of all, about breaking your miniatures, even if they are painted or highly painted like those. They slide easily with no effort. Maybe for me, because I'm sitting opposite of the camera, so it's not easy for me to show you. But you can see they slide with no effort. Again, the respective faction board. This nicely, we have six, I think, from each of the faction. Just removing the three in the front to show you the detail. I mean, no hassle there, easily removed. Just gonna remove one card for you to see. It's a tile, actually, it's not a card, but it's the tile of the faction that you can sit in the middle of the box vertically. I mean, this is a fantastic insert from LaserOx. And this is a Kickstarter edition, so it has all the expansion and the five player count, the full five player count. And I don't even have to turn the box now. It's that easy to remove. Again, you can see the drawings and the markings on each of the box, which is very nice detail. I mean, these guys pay a lot of attention to the details. They know their stuff. Obviously, they are board gamers, I assume. Only a board gamer could design such a detailed and functional insert. And you can see everything sitting together. Okay, one more angle to show you the detail of the boxes. We have, again, as we can see in the camera, the faction tile sitting vertically. You see there are three miniatures at the back, sliding very nicely together. Let me show you the detail. They're very rigid at their base. You can fit the tile in the middle like that and then easily slide the miniatures. They just almost position themselves very easily into the position. You see the detail? They don't go anywhere. And then you can do whatever you want and they sit nicely in their place. Very nice detail, very nice custom boxes for the miniatures and very valuable. We've seen the laser cut custom tokens. Let's take a closer look because here you have the Paradox. These are the original ones, just plain cardbox. And these are the laser cut ones. Very nicely done, nice detail. And you have an example of the nuclear tokens. Very thick engraving or whatever design on the top so you can distinguish easier. And here's an example of the yellow player tokens, how they look with the card box, very ordinary, and how fancy and nice they look with these thick laser cut tokens in the player color. Very nicely done. So this is it, a very functional and highly detailed custom insert for Anachrony from LaserOx Games. Very nice work, very detailed. We really recommend them. Give them a look